Namaskaram. Today we have with us two guests, Anu Menon and ex Lola Kutty. Two of them together write your life with us. So hope you're ready with your green tea, high tea and all the snacks because we are in here for a lot of laughs. And thank you for sending in your questions and all that you wanted to ask her. So she's here and we
Hello Shams. Namaskar. Hello Jay. Hello Dr. Sunita. Hasim here. Hello. Hello. Namaskaram.
Hi. Namaskaram. Chirta,
I am good. How are you?
Quite well. All things considering.
Especially the internet that we should check in today's time before we go live. How well is the internet?
I have had the worst luck with Insta lives, I'm telling you right now. It's just that technology hates me. It's nothing personal, but now I'm starting to think it is.
So you've given the disclaimer to the viewers already that, you know.
I think they're used to it by now. They're like, oh, and you know, at one Insta live, there was a comment also. Anu always has problems, you know, with connect house. During another Insta live, I changed four places. So the girl I was chatting with was like, Anu, I've seen all the paintings in your house. I was like, wait, there are two more.
I have changed going to my friend's house in the building also because the same internet for some reason has troubled me at times at my house but is working somewhere else. So I can correlate with you on this. So how is lockdown going?
Yeah.
Well,
I think initially I was just going from one pair of pajamas to another. Then I figured this is going to extend for a longer period than I initially thought. Also, I was running out of pajamas. Then I went through a phase where I was just wearing my evening clothes and looking extra dressed up in the house. So like some French maid from the 18th century, I would wear pearls and all in the house and do jhadu pocha, clean the bathrooms and all. So now I think, I don't know what it's like to step out of the house. Like how now when you enter your husband's house for the first time, you kick that pot of rice. Now, aisa hoga jab when I leave the house, you know, like ulta.
I can understand that whole thing because also the way you've been doing your live sessions and the Zoom sessions, you have created your own den in your own household. Every time there's some Zoom stand-up happening, Zoom, you know, those where you were giving the whole webinar of if you want to be a stand-up comedian and also you set your own den in the lockdown.
Yes. I just feel I missed out because I should have bought Zoom shares. Then I think all of us would have been fine financially. I was like, shit, chance is kiya maine.
Ab next time foresight ho jayegi na. So, you know, first one, like Lola Kutty already had the foresight of TikTok. You had the foresight of TikTok. Like, you know, aaj kal hum namaskaram hi kar rahe. And that's what she did. So she already had the foresight. So next time, listen, when you have an intuition, ki ye share kareena ki. So tell me, how did your journey start? How did you decide ki mujhe stand-up comedy karna hai, mujhe Lola Kutty character karna hai? How did all of this begin?
So basically, we have in this day and age, we have to go with chronology. It's a very important term, especially politically. तो अगर क्रोनोलॉजी ढूंढना है तो आई बॉर्न एंड ब्रॉट अप इन चेन्नई सो माय पेरेंट्स हैड मूव्ड फ्रॉम बॉम्बे एंड दे वर इन एडवर्टाइज एनीवे दे वेरी कूल एंड ऑल सो आई जस्ट थॉट आई एनीवे विल एंटर सम आर्टसी फील्ड सो माय मॉम वाज लाइक इफ यू रियली वांट टू पैशनेट अबाउट द स्टेज एंड स्टफ यू कैन स्टडी थिएटर सो आई वाज लाइक ओके सो आई वेंट टू इंग्लैंड आई गॉट पास स्कॉलरशिप डिड माय मास्टर्स इन ड्रामा The plan was I'll come to Bombay, I'll do theatre, but I'll get some TV job that will support the theatre habit. Because in theatre, mein koi, like, matlab, paise nahi bana sakte, na?
Ha.
So, utna foresight tha. So, I just met the head of Channel V and I was sent for an audition and Gaurav Kapoor was there shooting his show. So, he saw my audition and he told the boss at Channel V, like, listen, kuch toh hai is ladki mein, you meet her. So the boss was like, okay, you're cool, come hang with us, but I have to think of something to do. And also no one at that time believed that I was a South Indian. So it was like that whole, oh my God, she's too fair, she doesn't have buck teeth, she can speak some Hindi, you know. So it was all, she's but it was from Madras also, and she's a Malayali also, like, what is she? So I just thought it would be fun to be a character, you know, like someone you wouldn't expect to see on a music channel because you associated it with everything cool. And I was not cut out to be cool and say, yo, check it out, coming up next and all that jazz. And on one hand, there was Priya Trivedi, who was doing a show in a bikini at some random beach every week. And then there was me in Gajra and Chashma. And also the channel also was like, my God, ye toh risk hoga. But luckily for me, they took the risk. And that was the birth of Lola. And when I wanted to do stand-up, I was pregnant at the time. So then I thought, okay, maybe it was like too much to, with a big belly and all, to go on stage cracking jokes. I don't think the country is ready for this just yet. So so then I had to wait till my son was a little older in order to go. But I didn't, it was a two-pronged problem in that people would come expecting to see Lola, so they would be disappointed, thinking, ki, acha, she doesn't talk like that in real life. Acha, hair is shorter. Acha, she wears dresses. So it was almost disappointing to them. And then on the other hand, people are like, "Are, where do you do your nails? Where do you get your dress? What product do you use for your hair?" So, you know, it goes both ways.
So from Lola came the Wonder Woman, and though you had to wait for the bump to go and the baby to come, he gave you a lot of jokes. So whoever has seen Amazon special is going to relate to this whole thing, because you know the whole thing you've spoken about pregnancy and post-pregnancy with the baby and all.
Yeah.
So as a stand-up, obviously you look for masala around, and your Wonder Woman masala is all from home. So what was it when you were cracking jokes of people around you only, like all your loved ones?
Yeah. So the thing is, like, I guess because of my theater background, I'm more of a story comedian, right? So stories interest me, and then always I'll have a slightly more dramatic style than possibly another person. I like the very into political jokes or religious jokes, because I don't think there's anything funny there. Like, I find the personal things more interesting. At least I find the humor in that. That's why, you know, I focus on my family. And every time, like, suppose everyone's like, oh, you crack jokes on your mother-in-law. I was like, hey, every time she's upset, I just buy her a ticket to New York and she's okay. It's fine. Then if my son gets upset, paying for his education. So, acha, theek hai na? So, and yeah, so I like the, I think at the end of it, like, people will be like, you know, we know so much about your family, even though we know nothing, even though we've never met you, kind of thing. But like, even when I watch a comedian on stage, I get to know something personal about them. I really like that. You know, there is the human aspect of it, as opposed to just, acha, petrol prices, acha, Modi ji, you know, like that.
So, obviously, every child is special, but Lola Kuti or Wonder Woman, who is more special today for you? Atka diya na?
I don't think anyone is really, how can I choose? Matlab, nepotism bhi hai dud. I can't really choose, because there are also different times in my life, right? So, even today, overwhelmed with the affection and love that Lola Kuti as a character gets, because a lot of times you forget things. You forget things that you said as a character. You forget a lot of things that went into it, and then people will message you and remind you. Like, recently, I just put out a video as Lola because I was in costume. I didn't think much about it. But just, like, I was overwhelmed by the wave of affection, you know, and I think I became responsible for everyone else's nostalgia. Ki matlab, oh my God, you were my first crush. Oh my God, you know, you reminded me of my school and college. Then a lot of people started insulting younger people, like, Gen Z, you will never understand what music television meant to us because you don't know it. Your world is different. I'll just stop lecturing them, Bachari. But like, so I think if, like, humor, like many things, is always time and place. I'm very grateful for the time and place that people have given Lola. So yeah. I can't.
So while you were saying that, again, all the 90s, Wala have started missing the channel, and all your fans would have started Lola Kuti in a bikini, that would have been a sign to watch. Neen Sen says, all 90s baby Marilyn Hamlet says, she says, I miss those V channel days, and super sexy Lola Kuti, and creative researchers, and all of that. So all your fans are all on Lola, all again. They've got nostalgic.
Kuch bhi super sexy. You know, there used to be one super sexy calendar that Channel V used to release every year, okay? So all the cool VJs used to be on it. All the chicks used to be in like really like hotly styled and, you know, pretending to be washing a car and posing and oh my God and all. I never used to be on it. Because they were like, so Lola ko kaise sexy banayenge? So matlab, first like one producer tried also, nahi bichari, she'll feel so left out. Why don't we have Lola coming out of the ocean and all? They were like, nothing will help this girl. It's okay. Let's keep her out of it.
Again, go on and... Yes, I totally understand. But we have to wait for the internet to come back. So, okay, we had lost you. We were suddenly you. You're back.
I'm back. Okay.
We lost you after the calendar.
See? Even the internet didn't want me to be on the super sexy channel.
Yeah, that's what. The moment you said I wasn't there, sabhi internet yet. Tuck. All I could hear was, I'm like, okay, come back. So, tell me a compliment that stayed with you as Anu Menon, not as Lola Kuti, not as Wonder Woman, that, you know, something that on top of, you must have got amazing compliments when you are going everywhere, because obviously, you like, it's a privilege to have you live. But one compliment that's come to you right away on top of your mind, that this compliment has stayed with me.
I never remember compliments. I only remember the insults. So the most interesting insult I've received is, you're too pretty to be a stand-up comedian, but you're not pretty enough to be an actress.
Okay. This is really... I really don't know. Should we just take it as a backhanded compliment rather than an insult? No,
then I was told by a guy, listen, I just want to say that I would love to love you. So I don't mind through my life being known as Mr. Lola Kuti. But if you could just give me the chance, I would love to love you. And I was like, creepy much? Then he also said, oh, what is it like to remove the Lola sari? I was like, okay. It's not some Draupadi situation. Calm yourself.
So, you know, like you said, Anel doesn't support you in life, and we also witnessed it the moment you were even dreaming of being on the calendars, and Anel just gave up on you and we missed you on the night. But how does it feel? You know, you're in a different generation, like coming from the 90s and today's time, where you're performing on Zoom and literally you are performing where you don't interact with the audience, you know, while you're doing your stand-up or you're doing your webinar. So... Also, while Lola Kuti, that used to happen where you were performing straight to the camera. So how do you relate today performing on Zoom? Because not everyone has done that. So what is your advice to people who are performing on Zoom, the new generation?
I don't think like, look, the point is that Zoom is new for everyone, right? So you have to curb the kind of comedy you do as well, because it's a different medium. So firstly, if you are a very physical comedian and you like to move a lot, like it's hugely restrictive, like especially I find it hugely restrictive, right? The main difference is normally at a show, people come decently dressed to watch the show. But here it's like sab khoon maaf, because you are seeing a lot more than you bargained for. So I have seen people digging their nose, people scratching their balls, people in boxers, someone's mama doing jhadu pocha in the background, someone is latoing like an apsara on her bed. Like I feel like ye confidence mere ko chahiye hi chahiye life mein. So sometimes it's very disconcerting, you know, because you're so up close and personal with people. But, and also sometimes you're like performing in a vacuum because everyone's muted and someone's mama is giving them some, you know, danda for not sleeping on time, dood piyo, like all this is going on. Like it is very hectic to be on Zoom. I'll just tell you that.
So tell me, like, you know, you just did a webinar too on, for kids who want to get up and do stand-up, or anybody who wants to start stand-up comedy. And right now, there, thanks to the digital media, there is a lot more chances. There are a lot more open mics today. So what is the advice that you tell everybody who wants to do stand-up?
So if you really want to do it, you write those first 5 minutes and just do it, because nothing stops you. Someone asked me, they said, you know, should we do Zoom open mics? I was like, it's the best time, honestly, because you don't even have to leave your house. You're in your, you know, place of comfort, and you have, you know, if you have 5 minutes of joke, just there's nothing to hold you back. What's the worst that can happen? You can cry into the cushion next to you. It's right there. You know, unlike a regular open mic, you don't have to go physically to the venue, get booed, and then come back home and then cry. No, it's right there. So yeah, I mean, there is not much advice you can give people. You can only just tell them to go out and try it. And then they have to decide for themselves. Sometimes it's not even like they want to do it as a career. They just want that feeling, you know, to see how it is to tell jokes. Because you realize then there's a lot of difference between being funny in your, you know, by the office cooler, vis-a-vis you take that person with those jokes and put them on stage, right? So I think it's something that a lot of people want to try to get out of their system as well. So I would say now is the best time.
Was there any time in the beginning of your career when you went performing a set and you were like overconfident that, oh, these jokes are going to work and things didn't work out the way you thought?
I am never overconfident. Before every performance on stage, whether it's a corporate show, whether it's a regular show, whether it's an open mic, I am just gripped with self-doubt, and then I'll be like, why did I choose this? This is a horrible decision. I should have just been a lawyer or a banker. Who asked me to do this? It's like, you know, like crippling self-doubt. It's like you have an existential crisis. I shouldn't do this. Maybe I should be a housewife. Maybe I should, you know, like it's that. No one's going to laugh at my jokes. What was I thinking? I should never have studied drama. What will my parents say? Like it just goes from 0 to 100 in no time, right? And I think that's fine. Those nerves and all are good. Then you get on stage, and there's just something for me, I feel, about being on stage that you just feel at home. So anywhere you go, any stage in the world you go to, there is something very welcoming about it, which I always feel anyway.
What if you had to participate in one reality show post lockdown, which one would you want to participate in?
I have no idea, but I thought of performing in Jhalak Diklaja. I was thinking like if I should, but I couldn't at the time because my kid was too young. But otherwise, I seriously considered that. I thought, but otherwise I would not be cut out. Like Big Boss as well, never. Not a chance. I would not survive only. I'd rather die of starvation. But I was like, no, I can't.
What is the childish thing that you enjoy the most?
The childish thing that I enjoy the most, as a child, you enjoy these vague food choices. So that I do. Like on Mari biscuit, my latest is Mari biscuit and put the lather peanut butter on it. And I'll eat like 3-4 of those, sometimes 5. But I'm saying I'm bad at counting. But that is my new thing. And also when it comes to jokes now, if the joke is very clever, I'll be like, wow. So good. But I'll just still laugh at the banana peel wala joke. Like, that is the thing that makes me laugh. The clever joke, I'll be like, wow, well done. You know, that's the thing, yeah.
If it wasn't for comedy, what would you do?
I think I would have liked to be a lawyer, honestly. But I've also only the performing arts. I've never done anything else. Like I always say, like, unlike everyone, you know, they'll always be like, oh, I was an engineer, I was a chartered accountant, then I watched Tamasha and, you know, maine decide kiya ki main apna passion follow karunga and all. Nothing like that. I actually study drama. I'm sticking to what I studied. Isliye koi izzat hi nahi hai. No one says, wow, you know, Anu, you didn't waste a seat at an engineering college or IIT. But everyone who's overqualified to be a stand-up, they're like, taliya and all. I said, what is this? Yaar? Kaisi ulti dunya chalti hai?
If you had to name your life after a comedy movie, which one would it be?
Is that a comedy movie? I would say there's something about Anu.
Okay, if it wasn't for lockdown, where, like post-lockdown, where is a place in India you want to go and perform?
It's a place. I will go anywhere, Shweta. I'll just leave a house and go. The building niche karti hu na, matlab kuch bhi. So there's no choice. It's not like I'm going to say Australia and all. Nah. Anywhere. Just outside of the house.
वो पूरा ऐसे नारियल रखना, चावल भरना, डू द किकिंग ऑफ दैट थिंग बिफोर गोइंग आउट, दैट यू नो फाइनली आई एम गोइंग आउट.
या आई इवन द फोड़ो द नारियल ऑन माय हेड आल्सो, कुछ भी मतलब, व्हाटएवर हेल्प्स,
एनीथिंग टू गो आउट.
या या
व्हाट इज द फनीएस्ट प्रैंक?
माय फादर,
यू वर सो एक्साइटेड,
लाइक because I had to go out to the registration office because my family, some flat was being put on rent. So I had to go and sign the papers at one government office. And that was my only outing, first and only outing. I was like, yes, I'm wearing it. Then I put lipstick and then I was like, shit, mask to wear. So much for that. So then that was my big outing at the government office. I signed the bath. I'm like, okay. Now I'm back to the next 93 days of not going out anywhere.
Did the lipstick come on the mask? Were the people excited to see you full makeup, lipstick,
yes,
shifting?
Yes. So I was like, that's why, you know, now if you watch all these makeup influencers and all, now, before they used to give makeup looks with the mask. The mask pehen ke, they used to put makeup on the mask and all, okay? Now they've just started doing eyes.
Eyes. So
some big palm trees are growing, some dinosaurs are growing, because only thing you can see now are the eyes, na? So I was like, shit, this is a tough life, yeah? That's why if you look at any makeup brand that's on this, on sale, the lipsticks are the cheapest because no one needs it anymore.
If you had to sing a song on lockdown, which one would it be?
I think I should to make up one, that I am no one's lockdown lover. It's true, my husband's on ship also, has been on ship for 5 months. So I feel like, you know, when my mother said, what have you achieved in the lockdown? I was like, I am not an alcoholic. I think that is an achievement. I have, my husband's on ship, I've lived alone with my in-laws and my son, and I've not taken to alcohol. I feel like I'm so busy polishing my own halo. Like even Mother Teresa is like, wah, wah, wah. Like even like this is too much. So yeah.
Okay. Okay. What is the funniest prank any of your colleagues have pulled on you?
No one has pulled a prank on me as such, but there were, you know, these great Channel V versus MTV wars that used to happen, like these cute things. So I used to, Lola Kuti, the character, used to have an assistant called Alex. So people always used to think we were making fun of MTV because the head of MTV, his name was Alex Kurvilla. So, but that was completely false because this guy's real name was Alex. Okay. So one day, like on April Fool, like they used to do a show called MTV Bakrana.
Yeah.
So we just, so Channel V, like there was a guy, he took a lot of goats and just went and kept it in the MTV office. They were just roaming around. Are with goats on April Fool for MTV Bakra. Then the next day, then some biryani was sent to us. So it was just that, like this nonsense would go on back and forth. So that we used to enjoy.
So, okay, when in parties and public places, especially, you know, when you must be traveling around India, people have this habit, they must have come and told you, "Arey, joke sunana, joke sunana." So how do you react to that?
And the thing is, no, I never remember a joke. Yeah, it's the worst, because honestly, like comedians are the worst at telling jokes, like remembered jokes, you know, we're not good at it. So I usually just see, anyway, people think I'm sarcastic and rude. So then I'll just, you know, freeze them out and go. But yeah, I never even attempt. What's there to?
So do they come? Okay, if you had to produce and create a show, something like A Modern Family, which was revolving around you and your family, because like I said, Wonder Woman is all about your family. What would you call it?
If I had to do a show like that, I would call it Malu versus Malu.
But then what about the Guju?
Menon versus Mehta. Then okay, fine, we have to include them. Shit. Yeah. Menon versus Mehta.
Because if it just goes Menon versus Menon types, then how will the whole joke of your mom making the Guju food and all of that happen?
Because she is still Menon, no. So I was just hoping that the Gujus just made a special appearance. Shit, acha, theek hai, we'll involve them now. It's all one country. Fine, fine, I'll be generous. Oh, God. Ah.
So then Menon versus Mehta?
Yeah.
Okay. What a life you never take seriously.
Sorry, come again?
What a life you never take seriously.
I never take anything too seriously, or like I never take praise very seriously. I try not to take insults very seriously. So I try to maintain some kind of equilibrium. And I don't try to, I think in life, you don't take yourself seriously, but take what you do seriously. I think that's something I've tried to live by. My God, I feel like Oprah Winfrey. I'm so wise. Okay. Huh.
Like when I was talking that you tell you that, you know, you mentioned about your mother-in-law, you're cracking a joke on her and you're like, I'll buy a New York ticket. So every time your son sees a joke on himself or he sees some post that he's put on him, how does he bribe you?
No, he's too young also. He's 7.5. I said, see, if I have to pay for your material needs in this material world, Ayan, I can use you as material. So right now, you know, he doesn't have a choice. But see, at the end of the day, like a lot of people ask me this, my family does not have an issue with it. That's what I'm quite lucky that way. Like, you know, they don't have, they're quite open-minded, they're chill, like quite chill and stuff. So I'm very grateful for that. Like I wouldn't say something or put myself out there in a way that will make them uncomfortable. So that I'm quite quite conscious of and aware of. So a lot of times I've got hate from people who've taken offense on behalf of my family. So I was like, if my own family doesn't mind, should I be concerned about your opinion as a stranger in front of some strange computer screen in a strange town? Like, you are a modern, frustrated woman. How dare you say these things? Your son will do this to you one day. Like, just kuch bhi matlab. So I always say, you know, women sometimes are women's worst enemies. I think everyone just chills out a bit, you know. Have a glass of wine. It'll all be good. Huh.
So, how do you take comparison in today's time? Because lately, like, you know, everyone comes out and goes all open. You like this, that one like that. So when you read the comments, how do you take up the comparisons? How do you handle it?
Comparisons to other comedians?
Or just other comedians.
No, I mean, I don't think that a real, like the thing is this, the problem is that people put all female comedians in one box, right? So for them, all women only talk about boobs, bras and periods. And then I feel hugely pressured because I'm like, shit, now I have to write material on boobs, bras and periods just to justify the accusation, you know, because I don't have any of this material. So I think you have to understand that just like every man doesn't joke about the same thing, you don't lump all male comedians together, you can't do the same with women. The problem is it's a numbers game. There will always be far more male comedians than there are female comedians, right? So even when people say, oh, among my top five comedians, a woman doesn't feature. She doesn't feature because you've chosen your five favorite men out of thousands. Whereas the female will be sixth on your list, but you're choosing that out of 100, you know? So it's just purely a numbers game as well, I feel, at some level. I try not to read a lot of comments. Because also, I feel your primary duty, especially on stage, is to make your audience laugh. It's not to impress other comedians in the green room. It's not to, you know, people keep talking about, oh, you have to push the bar in comedy. Push the envelope, you know, raise the bar and all of these things. I feel there is also a beauty in a simple joke. And sometimes, and you have to play your joke according to the audience it is. So sometimes an audience will like a simpler joke, sometimes they like a highbrow joke. So you take a call to this where they'll be like, sometimes on stage, you never get defensive. They'll be like, oh my God, you know, I feel like that joke deserved a better response from the audience. Why? Every audience is different. They didn't care for it. They didn't care for it. Now the next audience will. So I feel like never get defensive about your jokes and your humor because everything is trial and error. So yeah, So that's like recently I was labeled a Hindu phobic comedian. Phobic with an
oh.
Okay. And I was like nothing also bugs me more than being insulted in bad English. Because so I was like, now you're labeling me this for what? Because they found a tweet of mine from like when my son was 1.5. He's 7.5 now. And this was my tweet. My 20-month-old son saw a picture of Ganesh and said, Batman. He's not entirely wrong. Both are super cool superheroes. Which is, you would think, a compliment, right?
So yeah.
Like, look at this. Hindu phobic comedian. इनके शोज बैन कर दो. आई वाज लाइक भैया शोज हो ही नहीं रहा है तो क्या बैन करोगे आप? जूम पे बैन करोगे क्या? मतलब
और ये है भी इतना पुराना. सो व्हाट वाज द होल एंड एक्चुअली व्हेन यू सेड इट आई एम लाइक इसमें प्रॉब्लम क्या है? आई वाज ट्राइंग टू डीकोड एंड आई एम लाइक ओके आई कांट फिगर आउट व्हाट द प्रॉब्लम वाज.
इट डजंट टेक मच. इट डज नॉट टेक मच. Because like now everyone wanted to come down on like comedians were some 5 days put together. They're all lumped together because everyone feels that oh comedians make a lot of fun of Hindu gods. And I'm like, well, I don't. I'm too busy making fun of my family. Where I've gone to Hindu gods now?
Yeah, like you don't go on political humor. You don't go on like abusive humor. You don't have dirty jokes.
Yeah.
So. After that, having this thing ki ban karo is quite surprising.
Yeah, really. I should give them a reason, no, at least.
You gave them, 7 years back. It just took them a little longer to figure out the reason.
My first son was like, did I say a bad thing? I was like, no, you chill.
So, while you make people laugh, what is it that you find the funniest and what makes you laugh the most?
What I like about making people funny, I think it's it gives you immense joy, no? To that someone is laughing at something that you have written specifically with intention to make them laugh. So the fact that it's worked, A, is great. The beauty is of stand-up. I hugely respect someone who takes a stand on something. I don't have to agree with your point of view, but you need to have a point of view. I actually never trust fence-sitters. Like, that's why, you know, like, you can't be Switzerland in life. You've got to take a stand on something, right? So that's what I feel. So I think what stand-up offers you is a unique perspective. Like, you and I, Shweta, can look at the same or go through the same incident and come out with two entirely different versions of it. And that for me is the beauty. That what my takeout from it is vastly different from your takeout of it. So whenever people are watching a stand-up, it's like either they empathize or they sympathize that they've been through the same experience, or they can't imagine having that experience, or they sympathize with you because you've had that experience. You know what I mean? So I think I always say at the end of the day, joke telling is truth telling. The basis has to be the truth. So don't crack a joke because you think it's the cool thing to say. Crack a joke because it's funny. The premise, like it's the premise that you believe in, you know. Like sometimes a lot of open mic, especially young kids, like they feel like shock value is important. Like an 18-year-old will come on stage and say, so, abortion. I'm like, no one's going to take you seriously because you're 18. What is your life experience? But they'll be like, no, but Louis C.K. said it. But Louis C.K. has done comedy for some 30 years and then he said it. Now, you also got to earn the right, I suppose, to crack a certain kind of joke at some point, right? So, yeah, I mean, it's a layered sort of thing. But at the end of the day, I always feel it's a beautiful feeling to be able to make someone laugh.
So while you make everyone laugh, what makes you laugh?
I think like anything, I'm quite a easy laugher. Like I laugh at, like I told you, the banana peel is what makes me laugh. I'll tell you what. Like when this whole locust thing was happening, oh my God, the locusts are coming and all. So someone said, the locusts should go to Sonu Sood if they want to go back home and he'll put them on a low cost airline. And I laughed so much at that. I laughed more for that joke than I had for 4 Netflix stand-up specials that I'd seen back to back. Okay. So my friend also said, listen, I said, I've lost all perspective. I don't even know what's funny anymore. Like, this is what has made me laugh. So also, like, the thing is, no, like, people get very judgy about, oh my God, it's not even funny. How can you laugh at it? But I'm saying, don't judge someone else's need to laugh at something, na? Like, everyone has their audience. So that's my thing. Like, people keep dumping down on Kapil Sharma. I was like, but he's earning 3 crores a show, na, buddy. Whatever he's doing. So just because you don't find him funny doesn't mean the man isn't funny. So I think a lot of people do this chajja and deep thinking about comedy, the layers, punching up, punching down. Just shut up.
Yeah, set punch tag. Like every time I see, and they're like, oh, so there are people who are learning and they tend to be like, oh, this stand up comedian had a punch and then she had another punch. And I'm like, okay. Can we just see the joke? Like, where is this punch tag happening?
Yeah. Yeah, because you need dissection, like how in science class you dissect a frog, na? So therefore in humor also, they feel the need to dissect. Achha, so the 1-2 punch, or then it's a callback, or then it's a caveat. I'm like, yeah, cool. You laughed or no, but enough.
Huh. Okay, so you mentioned about Netflix and the stand-ups you're watching. Who was your mentor when you started stand-up?
I didn't have any mentor as such. It was just something that I was giving a try. But if you ask me who I looked up to as a comedian, like of all time, I would say Joan Rivers. Like for me, like she's phenomenal, like man or woman, I think for her time especially. And she loved to dress up on stage. Okay. So she wore like these tight clothes to dress up, makeup. And she was doing stand up since she was like 85. So it's like, if you have to go, you have to go like that. Like, you know, that's amazing. She was sarcastic and caustic, and she did plastic surgery on her face, and she used to do whatever she wanted. And I think she's like, for me, all time. Also because you have to look at it for that time, right? A woman to be so brazen and bold and talk about anything, and then that ability to perform till like mid-80s, dressed up in high heels, she's to wear in her mid-80s. I was like, now only, like, after some time it pains when I dance. And now, so I was like, maybe I should practice at home only wearing heels. Like, on my birthday, we had 3 Zoom parties. I'm quite a party hopper. So 3 Zoom parties had back-to-back, and I wore heels, okay. So my friend said, you know, na, that on Zoom, we can't see your heels. I was like, but mujhe pata hai na. So, like, just let me be, dude.
So in lockdown, what are you binge-watching the most?
So for the longest time, I didn't have time only to watch TV because you're just like taken up by house. But I must tell you, this is what I've discovered, and I've talked about it a lot. But now, since they're friends and you don't even know it, I am going to tell you about my love for Korean drama. I have discovered it. I don't know why people have not told me about this. But it is. But you know, Shweta, you have to be prepared, okay? Like mentally and physically. Like only if your skin is in the best shape of its life will you be watching Korean drama. Because I was like, shit, that's why. I don't know whether they've done plastic surgery or their makeup products are so good. Because they are all, and the men are all prettier than the women. Yes. And all the men are into older women. I was like, thinking, like everyone's a Nick Jonas in that show, in Korean drama. Everyone. And the beauty is like Asian cultures are so similar, right? So they're like, they're in terms of respect for elders, like how they bow down, we do namaste. And even words, like in Tamil, we say Amma and Appa for mom and dad. And even in Korean, they say Amma and Appa for mom and dad. And I was like, I like all these like similarities in cultures and language and things like that. And now that's why I was like so used to just reading translation, like the subtitles, na? So now even I started watching the English, so I was reading it. I was like, calm down, na, no?
I saw you that too.
I was like, what's going on? It's too much now. It's a sign. I should stop. So I've decided the first place I want to go to is Seoul. I want to go to Korea and I want to be like the first, like I'll be like a plus size model in Korea. I feel like, you know, with my curly hair and all, some sort of exotic appeal maybe I can bring. My husband though is most unimpressed. Like he's like, listen, baby, all this while now I'm used to losing out to Ryan Reynolds and all that. I mean, yeah, ये गोंग यू, फिर क्या ये जी चैंग वो, सोंग जूंग की, नॉट द सेम, शट अप. एंड ऑल्सो लाइक बिफोर आई टू फील श्वेता, यू कांट ट्रस्ट अ मैन विद लेस हेयर ऑन हिज हैंड देन यू हैव. बट नाउ आई डोंट फील दैट. आई थिंक लॉकडाउन माई टेस्ट हैव चेंज्ड.
Okay, I have to watch this Korean drama now that you've spoken so much.
And please right now, watch Descendants of the Sun. Descendants of the Sun or Crash Landing on You. I'm telling you, you'll be fed up.
I shall watch that and get back to you on Crash
Landing we'll discuss
on the
it.
Sun. And, yeah, we'll discuss the Korean drama.
Yeah.
So tell me, usually, like, you know, my dad is a Menin, so...
Yeah.
So many of your jokes I easily relate to him, okay. Shekhar Menon. So, you know, like he'll say, Arey, veg, hum log nahi khate, and all of that. And majority times, the Sindhi side of my family will tend to tell him, because for them, it is like pura Chennai Madras, sab ek hi, Malayalam, Kannada.
Yeah.
You know, Tamil is all one. It's not like different. So,
Shweta, thank you for saying Malayalam. Oh, I'm so touched. I'm so happy. I can't tell you. Because I'm so used to people die but wake up kharab ho jayega. Continue, sorry.
I'm telling you, know, he's never called me specially with excitement, but with your life, he's like, are you today? When I said, Dad, relax. I know seeing the men in surname, you're getting super excited. But I understand, because for him also it's like, you know, like the moment he was Menin, he's like, oh, I'm from Palakkad, where are you from? And the whole, like, I'm like, everyone is from that one village. And the Sindhi side of my family tends to tell him, acha, say something in this language. And then he has to say, no, I'm a Malayali. This is different. Yeah. I'm not a Tamilian. I'm not from others. So do people tell you like that, ki South Indian mein kuch bol ke bata? Because for them, everything
Arre,
is
yaar. I have been married nearly 12 years. The other day, and I put on Twitter, so the other day my father-in-law said, my Guju father-in-law said, why don't you tell Ayan something and explain it to him in Kannada? I was like, then I said, it's actually easier for me to learn Kannada and explain it to Ayan than to remind my father-in-law that I'm Malayali. Because now, 12 years ke baad, if you've not got it now, so now you're never going to get it. Theek hai? So, कोई उम्मीद ही नहीं अभी. So, my mother-in-law plays it safe. She just says Mallu for both. Because you can. So, she's like, shit, otherwise I'll get it wrong again. She just says Mallu. She's my mother-in-law, my daughter-in-law is a Mallu. She speaks Mallu. And yeah. She's wearing a Mallu sari.
Like my nani doesn't get the difference between Mund and Lugi. She's like, those are same.
Yeah.
Wo Mund kyun hai? I'm like, and, you know, Dad tries to tell her, no, there is a difference between a lungi and a mund. And she's like,
Correct. Yeah. That's why, you know, sometimes when I watch, like, there's a certain swag also when you're used to wearing a munda, no? Like, these men especially.
Yeah.
Like, the way, like, if you see, like, some Dulkar Salman movies and all, there's one, like, the munda has its own, like, sequence, like, close-up sequence, okay? Like, like the munda is, becomes its own item number in the song. So, like, the way he'll just flip it, it comes so easily and so naturally when you are used to wearing it. It's lovely to watch. Compared to my poor husband who wore, like, boxers ke andar, he tucked the munda, then he put like two belts on top, then when he was going around the fire, he was like, baby, just go dheere na, because I'm scared the munda will fall. Then everyone will see my Bart Simpson boxers. I was like, why did you wear Bart Simpson boxers at our wedding? He was like, but they were new babies. My father's like, think of God, what are you chatting for?
But that is also one thing in South. Like, you know, I always tell that there is a God for every occasion. Matlab, har cheez ke liye ek alag mandir hai. So I'm like, till the mandir, you're vegetarian, and as you come out, you're back to being a non-vegetarian.
Yeah, but like I suppose, like, you know, for us, like on festivals, like we are vegetarian. The like a lot of Hindus are vegetarian, and then otherwise, but also now, see, don't remind me of this. I've been vegetarian since March 6th. Not that I'm counting like a loser. Stop it. So I feel, I'm telling you, no, I've become a sant. So my mother in Chennai, I was like, how are you surviving in this vegetarian household? how you will know I have no protein, your hair will fall. I said, it's already falling. Why is it falling? Put coconut oil. I said, in spite of putting coconut oil, it's falling. See, I knew it. I told you, you know, marrying vegetarians is very difficult. I was like, okay, next life I'll marry Gong Yu from Korea. He knows how to make really good chicken also, he said in an interview.
I am poster like going and watching this Korean drama for sure. इसके पहले कोई ब्रेकआउट रिकॉर्ड हो जाए स्किन फिलहाल परफेक्ट है लेट मी जस्ट वॉच
डूड आई गॉट अ जेट वॉचिंग एंड आई एम टेलिंग यू श्वेता एट वन एट सम टाइम्स ना दीज मेन आर शेविंग आई थिंक शेव क्या कर रहे हो आई हैव मोर फेशियल हेयर देन दे डू आई वाज लाइक डू यू इवन हिट प्यूबर्टी व्हाट इज गोइंग ऑन
ओके इफ यू हैड टू गो बैक इन एन एरा एंड मेक सम किंग और अ मोगल एम्परर और समबडी लाफ हु वुड इट बी
To make somebody laugh. No, I don't think I can go back in time. No, I can't because that time women were not even allowed to talk. Now stop it. What are you saying? We can barely talk now. So that's why we have Insta Live just to give each other a chance to talk. Otherwise, no one listens. I'll never go back. Mughal era, you're mad or what? Akbar will say, no, I'll just marry her. No need to have her tell jokes and all.
Okay, one word that describes you the best.
That describes me the best? Did you say one word? Incorrigible.
Okay. What is social media for you?
It is a full time pass. See, the thing is, it's not like a lot of people who it comes very naturally to. Like, it is an effort. Like, I have to remember. Like, sometimes, like, I'll can just eat a meal and I'll never remember that, oh shit, I should have taken a picture of it. Right. Whereas some people will like, you know, like a younger person would just come naturally to them. So they can think in Insta stories. I don't. So if it wasn't there, it wouldn't actually make much of a difference to my life. But I enjoy. I think also there are different kinds of social media, right? So I am much funnier, I feel, on Instagram than I am on Twitter. So I think the medium also makes a difference in terms of humor. And you've got to, actually Gaurav Kapoor said a very wise thing. He's like, when we were doing television, we were performing to people. Today, on social media, one is performing to an algorithm.
Yeah.
And that actually is pretty spot on in terms of, you know. So he always says, like, you know, sometimes quality over quantity is important. Just don't put up anything. It's okay. The people will find you. Rather put up one great video in 5 days than, you know, 5 videos a day just because you feel you need to feed that algorithm.
What app you use the most?
I suppose I check Insta the most. But apart from that, YouTube for whatever Korean show male interviews that have English subtitles. Hottest Korean male actors with washboard abs. I'm checking out that video. Actors who are above 5 foot, 6 foot, yes.
Korean mein hai, above 5 foot, 6 foot?
Arre, 6 foot, there are lots. So that's why I'm quite happy. At least height hai na. Baal nahi hai, but at least height hai.
Okay. Favorite comedy movie?
Oh, shit. I hate these questions. I get very confused, yeah, with these questions. Say, favorite comedy movie? Oh, my God. I don't have one. I don't have one.
Okay.
I really don't, actually.
Okay. One advice that Lola Kutty wants to give our viewers right now.
Please remember, when an elephant and a rhinoceros fight, only the ground suffers. I don't know if a rhinoceros and elephant have ever fought, but now even if they do, you know.
Okay, advice for the viewers by the Wonder Woman.
Arre yaar, I have no, like, I'm okay. I will give you my favorite line from Oprah Winfrey. If you see crazy coming, cross the road.
Now we're going to play a quick question, this or that, before we end our life. Popcorn or chocolate?
Chocolate.
Favorite chocolate, dark or milk?
Dark.
Tea or coffee?
Tea.
Nachos?
Unless it is filter coffee. Unless it's filter coffee, then like tequila shots, I will just go one after the other. My inner South Indian will come out and go five. I would have finished five, you'll be still on your one. Amateur.
Okay, we shall meet for a filter coffee session post-lockdown and discuss Korean drama.
Yeah.
Nachos or samosa?
Nachos.
Romance movie or action?
Romance, any day and twice on Sunday.
Favorite romantic movie that you watched lately?
Lately, I don't, but I love The Proposal. Like, I love Ryan Reynolds in The Proposal. It's so lovely. And then every time when I think of Blake Lively, I imagine her face on a dartboard and I just keep pushing the darts on that dartboard.
Disney or Marvel?
Marvel.
Favorite Marvel character?
Deadpool.
Musical or science fiction?
Musical.
Favorite musical movie?
Hamilton. I watched Hamilton recently. I love Hamilton. It's the perfect movie yet, but it should be. It's fantastic. Like it is outside. Like you will feel so talentless when you watch that.
Animation or horror?
Oh God, animation.
Favorite animation movie or character?
Favorite anime. I watched Coco with my son the other day. I'll tell you. We'll go with Incredible. Incredible.
Okay.
Yeah.
So thank you, Anu, for joining us live. And
thank you, Shweta.
We really enjoyed.
And Shweta, I must tell you, like, obviously, you're a very nice person because the internet didn't fail us as badly as it has in the past. There were usually, like, the comments are all just complaints. Oh, it's terrible. I can't hear her. Oh, the voice is breaking. It's cracking. There's an echo. There's this. It's bad. Her house is bad. So usually I'm just crippled with such low self-confidence. But so I think you have brought me good luck, Shweta. Thank you.
Thank you.
Maybe it's the Menon father that you have.
Maybe. Yeah. The Menon extension.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me. I enjoy this thoroughly. Thank you.
Thank you. See you post-lockdown and I shall connect with you post-Korean drama.
Absolutely. I look forward to it. Kansamida.
Namaskaram.
Bye.
Bye.